Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Echo Aftab. In my today's session, we are going to deal with the last concept that comes under utility analysis, and that is consumer equilibrium. So friends, with regard to consumer equilibrium, I would just like to brief about what were the previous topics that we have dealt under utility analysis. So under utility analysis, we started with what is the meaning of utility? Then we understood the first law, that is law of diminishing marginal utility, and with one commodity, how the consumer is in equilibrium. Then we went on to understand about the equilibrium of the consumer with regard to two commodities, and that is law of equimarginal utility. Then very briefly, we took up the topic of consumer surplus, and then we entered into ordinal analysis of utility. So under ordinal utility analysis, we got to know about what is the meaning of indifference curve, and then what are the properties of indifference curve. So as I had told that for consumer equilibrium, we need to know the concept of indifference curves. Along with that, we also understood about budget line. So today we are going to deal with consumer equilibrium, and myself Aftab Bhai. So without wasting time, let us move ahead to understand how the consumer will be in equilibrium when we speak about indifference curve analysis. Friends, consumer equilibrium can also be called as utility maximization when you speak about it in terms of mathematics. So let us see how the consumer will maximize his utility, or when will the consumer be in equilibrium. So let us start with a very interesting animation to understand about consumer equilibrium. So here we are having a seesaw type of thing. On the one end, we are having slope of indifference curve, and on the other end, we are having slope of budget line. So you can see both slope of indifference curve and slope of budget line are in perfect balance. Now we are having a consumer over here, a small little boy. Now he is exactly in center, balancing the slope of indifference curve and the slope of budget line. Friends, for any reason, if the consumer moves aside and increases the consumption of X commodity with regard to indifference curve, then what will happen? The slope of indifference curve will be more as compared to the slope of budget line. So in this situation, you can see there is an imbalance between the slope of indifference curve and the slope of budget line. So here the marginal rate of substitution of X for Y is more than the price ratio. This is just the beginning. You will understand about it in detail when we move ahead. Anyway, we have studied what is MRS in indifference curve analysis and price ratio when we are speaking about budget line. Now another situation, if this consumer increases the consumption of Y commodity, what will happen? Here the marginal rate of substitution between X and Y will be less than the price ratio. That is, the slope of budget line will be greater than the slope of indifference curve. And in both the situations, if the MRS is less or if it is more than the price ratio, the consumer is not in equilibrium. So we need to understand when will the consumer be in equilibrium. So to understand the main point with regard to consumer equilibrium is, here the slope of indifference curve should be equal to the slope of budget line. Or else we can say, what is the slope of indifference curve? The slope of indifference curve is marginal rate of substitution of X for Y, which should be equal to the slope of budget line. Now what is the slope of budget line? The slope of budget line is the price ratio of X commodity and Y commodity, that is Px by Py. So in the next slides, we are basically going to understand how is it possible to bring this MRS of X for Y equal to the price ratio of X and Y. So this is what is consumer equilibrium. So if the simple question is, when will the consumer be in equilibrium under indifference curve analysis? The answer is, the consumer will be in equilibrium when the slope of indifference curve is equal to the slope of budget line. Or in other words, the marginal rate of substitution of x for y should be equal to the ratio of prices of x and y. So let us move ahead and see. So what is consumer equilibrium? A consumer is said to be in equilibrium when he is buying such a combination of goods which leaves him with no tendency to rearrange his purchases of goods. This is the basic meaning of consumer equilibrium, or you can say it is a situation of balance in regard to allocation of his money expenditure among various goods. So as we can see here, we are making use of the word balance. So here, what is consumer equilibrium? He is trying to balance. What is trying to balance? His allocation of money expenditure. Allocation of money expenditure is our budget constraint among various goods. So here we have taken the case of good X and good Y. So that is with regard to marginal rate of substitution of X for Y. So this is the basic understanding about the meaning of consumer equilibrium. Let us move ahead and let us try to understand this concept with a simple mathematical example. So let us say, here you can see an Excel sheet is open. Here we are basically trying to see what is an indifference curve, what is a budget line, and what role does the utility play in this. So here you can see this yellow strip. Here in the yellow strip, I have taken a commodity that you can see over here. We have taken a commodity, and here in the pink shade, we have taken B commodity. And we have assumed over here that the price of A commodity is 40 rupees and the price of B commodity is 20 rupees. And one more assumption is that the consumer is having a maximum income of 400 rupees. This 400 rupees, the consumer needs to spend on two commodities, commodity A and commodity B. Commodity A price is 40 rupees per unit and commodity B price is 20 rupees per unit. Now let us see the game of numbers with regard to indifference curve and budget line. If I say the consumer is buying 10 units of A commodity, then what is happening? His total expenditure, you can see on the screen, is 400 rupees. So he will not be able to buy any amount of B commodity. So his expenditure on B is 0. But you can see his total expenditure is 400 rupees. So the first combination that he is buying is 10 and 0. On the other hand, if he increases consumption of B commodity, for that he needs to give up certain amount of A commodity. So now if he purchases 9 units of A commodity, you can see his expenditure is 360 rupees. Now he can purchase 2 units of commodity B and he is spending 40 rupees for that, and his total expenditure is 400. With regard to consumer equilibrium, friends, the main point of assumption is that the consumer needs to spend his entire income to maximize his utility, and that is what we are trying to see here. Now if he reduces the consumption of A unit from 9 to 8, his total expenditure is 320 rupees and he is buying 4 units of commodity B where he is spending 80 rupees and his total expenditure is the same. So you can see in all the previous cases, first situation, second and third, his total expenditure is the same. Now if he wants to increase one more unit of his consumption of commodity B, sorry, two more units, if he wants to buy two more units, he is spending 120. With the remaining amount, he is able to buy 7 units of A commodity. So his total expenditure, you can see again now, it is 400 units. Likewise, if he wants to increase the consumption by 2 more units, let us say 8 units, he is spending 160 rupees and the remaining amount, he is using it to buy A commodity. And here you can see, by spending his income on 6 units, his expenditure is 240 rupees and the remaining 160 he is buying 8 units of B commodity. Lastly, if the consumer buys nothing of A commodity, he is not able to spend anything on A and his total expenditure on A is 0, but he will be able to buy 20 units of B commodity and he will be spending 400 rupees. So you can see here in this column, I'll shade it for you, the total expenditure of the consumer is 400 rupees. That is the assumption that the consumer spends his entire income. Now, if I take these two commodities combination, first combination is 10 units of commodity A and 0 units of commodity B. So, this is the first combination. Then the second combination is 9 units of commodity A and 2 units of commodity B. So, you can see here a budget line is coming up into the picture. Similarly, if he is buying 8 units of A commodity and 4 units of B commodity, see the budget line, how it is changing the shape. With 7 units of A commodity and 6 units of B commodity, with 6 units of A commodity and 8 units of B commodity, and lastly with 0 units of A commodity and 20 units of B commodity, we are getting a budget line. So here in the graph you can see 20 is the maximum he can buy of B commodity and 10 is the maximum he can buy of the A commodity, and this line is called as budget line, also called as budget constraint. So this is the indifference curve analysis with regard to budget line. So we derived the budget line and we are saying that this is the line beyond which the consumer cannot reach. Now, just for our sake of clarity, as I told in my class of indifference curve, there are different combinations of goods which gives the consumer same level of satisfaction. So here, apart from the above example, I am taking one combination. Let us say the consumer is buying 1 unit of commodity A and he is having 20 units of commodity B. So you can see here the total utility that he is getting out of this particular combination is 4.4. How did we get this 4.4? I'll tell you later when we go back to our PowerPoint slides. So similarly, now let us say with this particular combination, the consumer is getting 18 units of satisfaction, utils of satisfaction from A commodity and 2 units of satisfaction from B commodity. Now, if the consumer increases the consumption of A commodity from 1 to 2, he has to give up certain units of B commodity. So, he will reduce his consumption of B to 10. Now, again you can see in both the situation, the total utility with 1 and 20, A and B is 4.4, and with the second combination of 2 and 10, even now the total utility is 4.4. As we know, as a consumer increases the consumption of one commodity, what will happen to the marginal utility of that? It will go on reducing. So here the consumer will increase the consumption of the A commodity, his marginal utility will decline and become 17, whereas the commodity where he is losing, there his marginal utility will increase. Similarly, for another combination, let us say for 4 units of A and 5 units of B, look at this particular column. What will happen to the total utility? The total utility is again the same. And if you look at here, we are deriving the indifference curve. So again, what is happening over here? His utility is decreasing from 17 to 15 because his consumption is increasing, and the stock of the good which is decreasing, there the utility is increasing. So similarly, friends, if there is a new combination, let us say 5 units of A and 4 units of B, what will happen? You can see in all these different combinations, his utility is the same. And lastly, his utility for those commodities where his consumption is increasing is decreasing, and his marginal utility where the stock is decreasing is increasing. Lastly, if this is another combination, 10 units of A and 2 units of B, so you can see we have got his utility has come down for the good which his consumption is increasing, and it has gone up for that stock of goods where he is giving up. So in all these cases, you can see, I'll just shade it for you. So here, this particular shaded area, I'll shade it in red. This red area is giving us something called as the indifference curve schedule. And out of this red shaded area, we have derived the indifference curve over here. This also, I'll make it black for you, red. Okay. So you can see in this chart what is happening, the indifference curve is derived. And here, friends, one very interesting thing, the total utility that the consumer is having in all the situations, we can see it is the same. It is 4.47. So in this case, you can say any combination, let it be combination A, or let it be combination B, or let it be combination C or D or E, what is happening? The consumer is having same level of satisfaction. That is, the satisfaction level is same, and that is why this is the indifference curve which is downward sloping, and here we call such an indifference curve as Cobb-Douglas utility curve. So here in this Excel sheet, I have covered what is indifference curve, this red shaded area, what is indifference curve. Then we understood about how the total expenditure should be the same when the consumer is spending his entire income, and how we have derived the budget line. And at the same time, we also understood why the utility will be same at the different combinations of the two goods A and B. So with this basic understanding, we'll go back to our slides. So graphically, in my indifference curve analysis, we understood what is indifference curve, and we also came across a topic which was called as indifference map. So here we are having x-axis and y-axis, and we are having a group of indifference curves which is called as indifference map. So here we are having indifference curve 1, indifference curve 2, indifference curve 3, and indifference curve 4. On the other side of the panel, we are having another graph. Here also we are taking X commodity and Y commodity, and you can see a straight line, and this straight line we call it as the budget line. So the panel A is indifference map and the panel B is budget line. So by overlapping both these graphs, we will try to understand the concept of consumer equilibrium, or how does the consumer try to maximize his utility given the budget constraint and his choice of different commodities with regard to different combinations. If you look at the graph, you can see here what is happening. I am overlapping both these graphs into a single graph. So here we are speaking about consumer equilibrium or maximization of utility of the consumer. So in this, you can see there are four curves along with the budget line. Now let us start with a particular point. Let us say this is point C. So what is happening at point C? At point C, friends, the consumer is buying certain amount of X commodity and certain amount of Y commodity. But here, if you see it, he is not spending his entire income. Our condition is that the income of the consumer should be spent completely. Entire income should be spent. So at point C, he is not spending his entire income. So this is out of question. So indifference curve 1, he will not be operating on it. Then let us take one more point, point D. Point D is also the same situation. Even on point D, he is not spending his entire income. So even this, we ignore it. Now comes point A. What is happening at point A? You can see at point A, the indifference curve, he is on indifference curve IC2, as well as he is on the budget line BL, or you can say price line. I would try to call it as price line. So PL. So what is happening at this particular point? The consumer is buying certain amount of Y commodity and certain amount of X commodity. But if you look at here, in this situation, what is happening at point A? Please pay attention. At point A, the marginal rate of substitution is greater than the ratio of prices of X commodity and Y commodity. So here the MRS is not equal to the price ratio. So there is possibility that if he reduces the consumption of Y commodity and increases the consumption of X commodity, he may be in a position to maximize his utility. This is one situation. Then the other situation is, let us say he is on point B. Now, with regard to point B, can you have the same logic applied over here, what we applied it for A point? So here, you can see, with regard to at point B, again the situation is somewhat similar but in an opposite way. So here the marginal rate of substitution at point B is less than the price ratio of X commodity and Y commodity. So if he is on point B, what is happening? He is buying this much units of X and this much units of Y commodity. So here if he needs to equate it, so here MRS is less than PX by PY. So what he has to do? He can reduce the consumption of X commodity and increase the consumption of Y commodity. So if this is the situation, there is one point which is the ideal point. But before that, this is the Z point. As we know, higher the indifference curve, higher will be the level of satisfaction. So in this graph, IC4 is the indifference curve which is visible and which is highest. But this Z point, it is not achievable. It is, the consumer will not be able to reach, Why? Because his income is less. His income is given by PL, price line, budget line, and Z is out of reach. So even this is out of question. So now what happens is, if the consumer is at A point, he will go on decreasing the consumption of Y commodity. If the consumer is on B point, he will go on decreasing the consumption of X commodity. So ultimately there will be a point, and that is point E. And you can see what is happening at E point. The consumer is in equilibrium, because at this particular point E, the budget line and the indifference curve both are touching each other. They are not intersecting each other, they are touching each other at point E. You can see budget line is tangent to indifference curve 3. So C is on the lower indifference curve, D is on indifference curve 2, A point is also on indifference curve 2, B point is also on indifference curve 2, and even D is on A indifference curve 2. So A is equal to D is equal to B, but D is, the consumer is not spending his entire income. At A and B, the consumer is spending his entire income, but the indifference curve is intersecting the budget line. It is only the point E, that is by reducing the consumption of Y, and reducing the consumption of X at point A and point B respectively, the consumer will be able to move at point E. And at point E, when the budget line is tangent to the indifference curve, we call the slope of budget line is same as the slope of indifference curve. So, what is the slope of budget line? The price ratio of X and Y, which is equal to the marginal rate of substitution of X and Y. This is what is consumer equilibrium. So, when will the consumer be in equilibrium, friends? The consumer will be in equilibrium when this condition is met. So, in my mathematics class, we speak about utility maximization. And when I speak about utility maximization, we are trying to prove mathematically how the slope of budget line will be equal to the slope of indifference curve. So, this is all about consumer equilibrium. In my Excel sheet, I had shown you one particular formula. So, here friends, when you speak about U is equal to F of X and Y, that is two commodities that the consumer is using, or else we can say U is equal to F of A and B. So, here A and B can be either of the commodity, or X and Y can be either of the commodity. So, Cobb-Douglas utility function. In my mathematics series, I have spoken about production function. So, Cobb-Douglas utility function, it is something like this. U is equal to A raised to half into B raised to half. Or else you can say U is square root of A into B. So, in my example, what did I do over there with regard to indifference curve? So, what I did was the first combination I took. So, A is equal to square root of 1 unit of A into 20 units of B. So, that is square root of 21, and that is equal to 4.72. Similarly, another combination I took, that is square root of 2 into 10, this is 1 into 20, 2 into 10 square root of 20, this is again 4.72. The third combination that I took was square root of 4 into 5, that is square root of 20, and here again you can see 4.72. So, if this is units of A commodity and this is units of B commodity, then this is our utility. So, different combinations of two commodities giving the same level of satisfaction, this is what is called as indifference curve, and this indifference curve is exhibiting Cobb-Douglas utility function. So, this is what is the taste of mathematics for economics. All the problems that comes under this thing, I will be taking up in my mathematics for economics playlist. So, friends, thank you very much for being with me. As usual, today we have completed utility analysis. Now, I am going to begin with demand analysis, where we will be understanding about law of demand, elasticity of demand, increase and decrease of demand. So, friends, till then, please take care of yourself, enjoy your life, and thank you very much. Thank you very, very much for being with me and watching my videos on in Understanding Economics with Professor Aftab. So, till my next video, please take care of yourself. Ta-ta. Bye-bye.